Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and this is Scout and Shibumi sleeping, keeping us come here a little bit later in the morning because I took some time for kitten cuddles. So we have been talking about some pretty heavy stuff in the studio recently, and here behind the scenes, we've talked about comparison. We've talked about creative loneliness through the David Bowie piece. I think we've connected to a sense of loss, and we've been talking about art wounds too. And this morning I was thinking about drawing, which is where a lot of my art wounds are. And I'm currently taking Wise for Yellow with Carla Sondheim. And the first exercise is to do with drawing. So I've kind of been replaying my history with drawing. And I realized that, you know, right off the top of my head, I can come up with the stories that shut me down, the stories that made me believe that I had no talent for drawing. But underneath those stories, I was also able to excavate a whole lot of love. Because usually those places where I got shut down started with me doing something, you know, me really immersing myself in something or sharing something with great love. And I was remembering in grade 5, in my public school, one of the coolest things to do on the holidays was to paint the windows with art. And in grade 5, one of my greatest moments of pride was my drawing of a very simple candle being chosen to go on the window. See, I'm still beaming with pride on the window for Christmas. And I can literally still feel what it was like to sit up on the ledge of the window, to take a crayon and create with great focus and love and commitment to doing a good job that candle. Oh. And what I felt there was my intense love of drawing, my intense love of creating something simple with my images. And one of the things I learned when I took the line drawing class with Lisa Congdon at Creative Bug, and I can't recommend that enough. I can't, in fact, recommend Creative Bug enough. It is a subscription-based offering, but it's under $10 a month. So it's more accessible than a lot of other things, and the classes are great. And Lisa currently has a class of drawing 31 things in 31 days, and it is filling my Fobonichi, little drawings of owls and watches and brooms and tulips. But through my experience with Lisa Congdon, I started to understand that my drawing aesthetic, my natural impulse to drawing, is two-dimensional. I like shape. I like line. I like simplicity. And when I was little, I got the impression that drawing was only, you know, three-dimensional realistic rendering of an apple or a leaf or a cat or a bird. And so that wasn't what was in me. And so that was a revelation for me that actually maybe there is something there for me. There certainly is love for me. And I'm sharing this with you to encourage you to look beneath your art wound stories and find the love that's there. I feel like it's looking for the bit of healthiness, the bit of fresh soil underneath the part that's been damaged, the part that is still fresh with possibility and ready to be nourished and grow. So look for the love. One of the things that started me thinking about this is I'm so thankful. My sister Susie gave me a couple of wonderful Lisa Congdon coloring books for Christmas, including this geometric patterns one. And one of the things I love, and this is something we can do with our coloring books, is not just color in them, but take inspiration from them for shapes and lines and drawings and doodles. I mean, don't you just want to doodle that? Or maybe you don't. Maybe you want to make realistic drawings of birds and cats and trees or buildings or bicycles. And I think that's a part of discovering our unique artistic voice. So that's another thing too, right? Is stay out of the world of judgment, of deciding that one form of expression is superior to another, either that ours is superior to someone else's or that someone else's is superior to ours. And instead to just enjoy with great delight the variety that is available. And I have to say, so yesterday night, I opened this up and I looked at this and I was like, what? Look how fun that is. And I filled up a part of my Fibonacci page with lines and drawings just like this. And it was so meditative and so fun. So I think in this too is the idea of not only if that seems fun to you, that I hope you'll look for shape inspiration. You can find lots on Pinterest too and allow that to inform your doodles. And sometimes that can be a great bridge if you find drawing intimidating, is to just, well, all I'm doing is drawing a triangle, for goodness sake. I can draw a triangle. Or, oh my goodness, I can color in a triangle. Let me pick three colors and I will draw triangles all over a page and just use these three colors and see what I create. Wonderful, wonderful. So I think that the key is that we find a way to open the space, to gently breeze away the parts that are old and not useful anymore. And underneath, find where there is love and life and possibility. So I hope that inspires you to get to your art, to trust and love what you are drawn to. And also, if drawing is as tender for you as it is for me, especially, I hope it inspires you to give it a try, to take a little page in your journal, or if that's too intimidating, just a scrap piece of paper, and just draw some lines, draw some triangles, color them in, keep it simple. Scribble. My goodness. Scribbling is like, it's such a good way to get the energy out. It just might help clear some of those art wounds. And if you do explore and find some of your love stories with art, I would love to hear them. I'm kind of imagining a chapter in my book there, right? Thanks for hanging out with me this morning. I already am looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. Have a great day in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio.